Hi, Magic Image Hollywood magazine viewers. It's Bree Strohmeyer, and today we're sitting down with Plastic Surgery to the Stars. You know him as Dr. 90210, the very man, Dr. Robert Ray.
I look a little bit like a terrorist today. More like a terrorist than a plastic surgeon, but you know, plastic surgeons are the rock stars of medicine.
That's right.
A little bit. Although I think I went a little too far from the rock star to the terrorist, but...
Look, it looks good.
You like it?
Yeah. The highlights and everything look really nice. We're just going to go into a little bit background-wise about yourself. Not originally from the U.S. Tell us about your heritage.
Well, it's funny you say heritage. I did an interview today where they looked at my DNA. I looked at Mary Lopez's DNA, looked at my DNA, a couple of known Latinos, and they wanted to know exactly who we descend from. And so, what do you think I discovered?
I don't know. What did they uncover?
Portuguese and Spanish. Duh. But a little bit of German.
Really?
A sprinkling of Polish. Polish? a little bit of Jewish, because all of the, in this hemisphere, most Latinos have a little bit of Jewish because of the Spanish Inquisition, of course. A little bit of history there, but, and a sprinkling of African.
Interesting. So you grew up with all that in Brazil and then you came to the U.S.
Yes, and my dad was a hero in the American Air Force. He bombed Rommel over northern Africa. And
so did you move when you were a kid? Or
my father went to Brazil after the war, married a Brazilian, so I'm half American, half Brazilian, a dual citizen. But I was raised in Brazil, my dad was not involved. One thing led to another, ended up drifting down the ladder of society, ended up at the bottom, was a petty thief, robbed stores, two or three times a week.
Wow.
Lived, very bad, below blue collar. And one day there was a knock on my door, and two American Christians, Christian missionaries, looked around to this ghetto, basically, and said, it's kind of bad for the kids to raise here, and offer my parents. My parents are always on a different planet. I said, listen, we'll take these kids from America, we'll raise them for you. And my parents were so happy to get rid of four kids. And so at 12 years of age, my parents, whatever little money they, so the Christian missionaries offered to raise us, but they went back to America, so we were to meet them in America. So my parents scrounged up some money together and bought us a passage in a cargo ship.
Oh, wow.
So I literally arrived in America in a banana boat. And that's why I'm a second degree black belt. Because all through high school, kids give me a hard time. Because I arrived in a banana boat.
That's right.
And, one day I was coming to, it was 19 days in the ocean. One foggy morning I woke up. I looked in the ocean and there were chains in the ocean. I'd never seen that before. Our cargo ship. Going through lanes of chains. I looked up out of the fog, I saw Lady Liberty. And I knew then that there was a chance of success if I worked hard.
And once you got here, what inspired you to go, obviously, into the profession that you went into, which was plastic surgery?
Well,
did you know that you wanted to be a doctor? Did you know this is what I was going to do? Or what made you decide this path?
Brazilians, we are very colorful people. We're very happy people.
And very beautiful.
Oh, thank you. Germans make cars, Italians make shoes. Latinos created sensuality. Look at the tango, the samba, the salsa. Well, we contribute to the world. We made this dreadful existence sexy. So we created sensuality. And Brazilians are kind of hypersexual. So we like the form, the human form. And more specifically, I love females.
Okay.
I've never met a woman I didn't like.
Oh.
Finally met the exception, my mother-in-law. But other than my mother-in-law, there's no woman. I love women. Almost an obsessive degree. And My mother-in-law? Never! No, I'm just kidding. I just love women. And my mom was a saint, my father was just a monster, so you'd have to be Freud to figure me out.
Right.
Right? But I'd be Freud to figure me out.
And so now I'm
a woman worshiper.
You make them more beautiful.
I like science, I love women, I love form, and a very artistic soul. I have the music in my soul, so the perfect combination of science and art is plastic surgery. Because it's exactly in the middle.
Right. And that kind of, our next question is sort of, you are a scientist, you're an author, you do all these things. Tell us about some of the other multifaceted
only
of,
guy that works.
Of Dr. Ray. What are some of the things you're up to?
Well, you know, I'm running for Brazilian Congress this year.
Something we didn't know?
Because
would that make you, you'd have to go back there then, right?
It's not like American Congress. We do the Latino way. As long as I'm there for most of the votes, it's good. It's just that I want to make a contribution in American politics too. I think Latinos are, we're 51% of the state, but we're voiceless. Mm-hmm. A lot of people, when they pass, the guy who parks your car, you don't even look him in the eye. And that hurts. When I arrived in America, they said, you know what, we go to church here, but the Mexicans and people like you go to church there. And I thought, oh no. I thought it was the country with no racism.
Right.
And so definitely want to make a contribution here. But I got my master's degree in government from Harvard. And a lot of people in my class are presidents now, or in Congress. Maxine Waters was in my class.
Okay.
President of Mexico was in my class. Obama was there when I was there. I had a class of 90. Well, Obama was 91. So I wanted to help the Latino condition in America. Mm-hmm. So at some point I'm going to serve as a congressman here. But as I look back at this misery of my own country, most of Brazilian politicians have been uneducated. And they try to run a country without education. So I figured before I do that, I'm going to try to improve health in Brazil, improve the standard of living in Brazil. So I'm going to donate 4 years to Brazilian government, and then I'm going to come back.
That's
fantastic. So, you know, I go there, do the votes, and come back. So I'm still in town. But I go to Brazil every week anyhow.
So you can do both.
I have a television show in Brazil. As is, every Tuesday I film for Brazilian television in Brazil.
Got it.
That's why I'm going to Brazil now. In Venezuela's.
Now, we're staring at some things on your desk, and they've the gentleman has a lot of fun playing with them.
Boom implants. Yes.
Tell us about your clinic. Tell us about some of the things that people come to you for.
You
mentioned
here.
Some very interesting things that you are perhaps even more interesting than me.
Yes, a lot more interesting it is. The first stop used to be an agent. Today the first stop is your plastic surgeon. So the girls get off the bus from Minnesota or South Dakota or even the overseas from Europe or whatever, they already know the first stop is a plastic surgeon. Then, I did a movie as a matter of fact, with Bo Bridges, was called Americanizing Shelley
in
Universal Pictures. And basically the idea was that big, big actress in India, but when got an agent in America, first thing the agent did is to escort her here to see Dr. Ray, because there's a certain boob and a certain tush and a certain, there's a standard here, obviously, as you can see from the magazine cover.
Right.
And so we were the first stop, and everyone's very nice to me. Police doesn't give me tickets. Why? You get hit in the face as a police officer, they take you to the emergency room, guess what the pretty face you're going to see first?
Yours.
And so if you're mean to me, you give me tickets, to your horror, I'll be the first one you see at Cedars-Sinai ER. So everyone's nice to me.
Right.
The models are nice to me. The producers are nice to me. So it all starts in this.
And obviously, in this town, everybody wants to stay forever young. So that's just some of the other things.
You know, I don't criticize it because movies, entertainment brings a huge contribution to American gross national product.
Mm-hmm.
In a country whose exports are slipping and slipping and slipping. I mean, what exports America has now?
Right.
What exports does
very
America
true.
Have now? It turns out that Hollywood, as much as we get criticized, is a huge contributor to the gross national product of America. But there's a lot of pressure. This is what they're looking for. I'll be honest with you, beautiful people is only 4%, at least what they taught me in residency, unless residency was wrong. Only 4% of the world is beautiful. This is a uniform for Hollywood. These things do not occur in nature. Look at this. This does not occur in nature. See this quad? I want you to look down at this quad. See this quad? This quad here, this is ours in the gym. The vastus lateralis does not grow by itself. Take a look. Look at this. Mm-hmm. This perfect upside down heart, this is not an accident. None of this is an accident. Look, this is not what the average woman looks like. This takes effort. This takes effort.
This is not
a really good pair of
This is not how eyebrows would work. This is not human eyebrows do not grow this way. This is done in anesthesia. So we do a lot of things from head to toe. We do a lot of surgery in the feet.
The feet.
We do a lot of surgery in the feet. Why? Two words why we do surgery of the feet. Two words. What do you think it is?
Because you want to wear really bad shoes for your feet.
That's seven words. Why? What's the two words? Jimmy Choo.
Oh, well, yeah. Or one word. Louis
Vuitton. Yeah, look. Oh, yeah. Oh, my God. It's a good thing you didn't marry you. Expensive things. Anyhow, so we do a lot of rhinoplasties, and really we're able to... Girl comes in like this, a girl from Eastern Europe, came wanting to be an actress. Pretty girls from Eastern Europe.
But she's pretty.
But sometimes a little bit coarse, you know what I'm saying? And I just feminized her nose. Look.
It's a beautiful nose.
That was a cool girl. Look, just cool girl here. But maybe a touch of masculinity to her. I just feminized her, but you don't even know I was there.
Right.
Gone are the days of those Michael Jackson. Plastic surgery results.
Do you ever tell anybody no? Or that's too much?
We had the highest rejection rate on earth. Luckily today, Haley and I no longer have to practice, you know? Mm-hmm. Thank God. I got Dr. Ray Shapewear, Dr. Ray Creams, books, seven products worldwide. Lin Zhou, Ray. My wife's idea. Anyhow, how could you not want to? This is what I make. How could you not want, you're obviously natural, but this is what I make. Mm-hmm. How could you not want to do this, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
I do it, but a lot of girls come in, very typical. They walk in just like this, and they say, Dr. Ray, I want lipo. Lipo of what? This is less than 3 millimeters. The normal on a person who's totally ripped, normal is 1 centimeter. You have 3 millimeters. Mm-hmm. You can't even have your periods on 3 millimeters. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You don't have enough fat to make your hormone even. Mm-hmm. So they walk in like this.
And want something.
And they want lipo. Lipo of what? And they come in perfect, and I understand why. Because I, myself, went to auditions. Mm-hmm. Can you imagine doctors do auditions? I walked in thinking, ha 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 ha. I'm a Harvard brother. I'm a Latin brother. Oh, of course I'm going to get this. I walk in. It was for a soap opera. Mm-hmm. I saw 150 perfect-looking doctors.
Right.
Forget all the models. I'm just talking about just in the narrow world of doctors thinking,
it's going to be easy.
This will be nothing. I pick up my jaw off the floor. 150 perfect-looking, GQ-looking doctors. Real doctors. I'm not even talking models dressed as doctors. Welcome to Cali.
That's right.
So in Cali, there's a lot of pressure to look a certain way. And like I said, this eyebrow, this is not how human eyebrows grow. Somebody made that eyebrow. You know what I'm saying?
Me.
Somebody plucked that. You know what I'm saying? And this is work. Hair and the... You know, I spent the summer in Africa, and I see people in their natural element. By 32, they look like our 72. Mm-hmm. In their natural element, humans don't look like this.
Right.
And so to look like this, like a goddess, you have to, it takes effort.
It does.
And we are here to help you. But we do even show more shocking, so the boobs and the noses and things are all, everyone knows about that. But did you know I can do a girl's boob through her vagina?
Why would you do a girl's boob through her vagina?
So we don't scar her. So we don't...
Why not through like her belly button?
We do it through the belly button.
Okay.
But if they're a mommy and I'm doing a tummy tuck anyhow, getting rid of the stretch marks, one finger above the vagina, I can do her breasts.
Really?
So instead of making multiple holes on her. There's already a hole there. So we do it through that one, and it's just a little implant. And it just, think about it. If you were a plastic surgeon, would you fill a girl full of holes?
That's very true.
Right? And so we don't. But speaking of vaginas, we do a scary number of vaginas.
Really?
So you think, that guy is really nuts. As soon as I flip this opening, I say, oh my God, right. Thank God he does vaginas. Can you guys handle it? Is this a family show?
Edited out.
So we do a lot of butts, of course, right?
What's the most common right now?
Most common thing we do, of course, still breasts,
really?
But breasts is losing steam fast. Okay. Breasts are almost, this is the end right now. Breasts, the Baywatch look,
gone.
Totally gone. No one even talks about breasts anymore. Breasts is unimportant. Today,
the butt?
All about the butt. And so we used to put an implant in the butt. I scoot forward. Let me just show you. So this is the body implant of the past. Feel it. It's like sitting on two wallets
so that's not comfortable.
For the rest of your life. So it just looks good, but if somebody pinches you, it's going to be hard as a rock. God forbid you get an injection or you get vaccinated. I've seen lots of girls do that. They call me back, Dr. Marie, I'm going to Europe, I got vaccinated, I'm going to Africa, I'm going to Asia. Where did you get vaccinated? In my butt. You idiot! You injected my implant! You idiot!
That doesn't look very comfortable.
Not very comfortable. Those days are gone. Today, I'm sorry I ended up on the vagina page. But you have one of those, so it's all good, right? I hope you have one of those. In Brazil, they can look like this and still be men.
I assure you, it's all there.
Okay, so in the old days, we had a big hole in your tush. Look how big that hole is. Wow. That's not number two. That's another hole I made in your tush. And we shoved an implant in it.
Oh, wow.
Gone. Those days are gone. Very close to sciatic nerve. We could make you paralyzed. We never did, but it was a risk. Today, how many months later do you think this is, before and after?
Months later?
15 minutos después. That's 15 minutes later.
Wow.
No holes, no incisions, nothing. So I asked the girl to gain 5 pounds for me, right here. Because of course I cannot do anything with this. She gains 5 pounds. I take those 5 pounds off, so ice cream for 2 or 3 weeks. Then I take it from here, I throw away the fat. So this is stem cell, far better than the old butt implants. So this we throw away, the grease, of course we throw away. We keep the stem cells. Inject them, get this beautiful little porno butt. I covered Brazilian Carnival for a Brazilian television show. And pretty much every butt I saw in Carnival was man-made. So those perfect butts you see.
Are not easily come by.
They're fat transfer.
So what do you think is going to be the biggest...
For now, vagina.
Well, yes, fat. But what, beyond all of this, what's the next up-and-coming thing?
You know, we're going to get rid of facelifts.
And for what?
Lasers. Lasers. So that $20,000 facelift with that artificial wind-blown look, gone. Today the lasers will tighten your face. For $500 instead of $20,000, and it lasts a year. How long does a facelift last? 2 to 7 years.
2 to 7 years.
On the average, 3 or 4. If that, it falls right back down.
And lasers will be less expensive.
And lasers are very, very inexpensive. So we're going to less and less and less and less, cutting more and more lasers and things like that. So, if you think I'm nuts, this girl, so these girls are all shaven, so the days of the big forest here, everything hidden, gone.
Existed, so.
They act like they don't know what I'm talking about, but they themselves have had it many times. So, girl said, Doc, my God, my boyfriend's already seen me naked. I don't care about that. I'm going on my honeymoon on the beach in 6 weeks, and I don't want to have fullness here like a boy. Reasonable question, right? So, we trim everything internally, but no scars. So you see, just when you think it's crazy what we're doing, when you see this, you realize, not so crazy, I'm glad he exists. And I have some very famous singers in here. It's a good thing their face is hidden. Darkness, girls don't like darkness. Mm-hmm. They don't like this to be a different color than this.
Right.
So we lighten it for them. Lopsided.
Mm-hmm.
This is crazy. We just make everything connect. And it takes 45 minutes, half an hour, 45 minutes.
And recovery time is?
Nothing. Mm-hmm. Just no motorcycle riding or horseback riding for 2 weeks. That's it. I don't have to explain that one, right?
Exactly.
It's simple, right? Plus, it's really simple. This. We don't care. We don't care. But the girls don't do it for us. Maybe once in 21 years a girl said, I'm doing it for my boyfriend. Never. The girls don't, they don't do it for us. We're happy just to be there. They do it for themselves. Do you think this can erode your self-confidence?
I'm sure it could.
It can. I'll help you. It erodes a lot. Look at that. And look how pretty we make it. Just everything fits together. Same color. Everything fits.
Mm-hmm.
Done.
Very impressive.
You cross your arms and your legs. Why? That told me everything you didn't want to say.
lots of good information there.
All so. Pretty girls stand in Jenny Valdez. Look, plastic surgeons, we get asked to do a lot of bizarre things, right? I refuse to do wet t-shirt contests for Las Vegas hotels, but I do the high-end stuff. Miss Universe, right? So I worked Miss Universe. I did judge for Miss Brazil twice, Miss Venezuela once, Miss South Africa once, Miss Honduras once, Miss USA. So, I not only make beauty, I know beauty, right?
Mm-hmm.
All pretty girls stand in Jenny Valdez. I don't know why, but I'll show you what that means. Genu, ni, valgus means in. All pretty girls stand like that. I don't know why.
Well, I also have a passionate background, so that can very well explain it.
All pretty girls stand like this. Every girl stand like this, pretty girls stand like that. I don't know why. You had a what background?
Passion.
They're miserable, aren't they? They're brutal.
Hey, I learned a lot. So, back
brutal.
To you, though. Obviously, if you weren't a surgeon, you weren't making all these people over and making them beautiful, you would be doing what?
If I was
you're actually kind of living
surgeon, what a great question. Oh my gosh, are you serious? It's like being locked in the chocolate factory. Are you serious? This is like paradise.
But
anything
you haven't yet conquered.
But now it's time to give back, you know? So I'm entering the give back phase of my life.
Obviously, Congress.
I'm going to help Brazil first, and then I'm going to come back to America and do something here. So I want to do something in government.
Very good.
Primarily, Brazilians have been uneducated, so they try to run a huge country without education. They did okay. I want to give them a hand, and then America, just because there's so much still inequality here.
Yeah. Well, I think we're going to wrap it up there since you took over my interview. I didn't have to ask you questions.
Oh my God.
It was easy.
I like it. Very, very cool.
Oh yes, the magazine.
I need a photo so I can Twitter it.
Wonderful magazine.
Very nice magazine. I like it.
It's not me on the cover though.
Whoever it is, I want to be there. No, I'm just kidding.
She'll probably be in here.